is my everything. Can't you see? It's my everything. Whoa. Welcoming you from Asia, welcoming you from America, welcoming you from Europe, from Africa, from South America, from every part of the world that are currently watching this video. I want to say that God will bless you, and God has led you to come and watch this because He knows that there are informations that you need to get from this. The Bible says something in the book of Proverbs chapter 11 verse 9, that by knowledge shall the righteous be delivered. So knowledge and understanding, very, very important for the life of a believer. And it's by that knowledge that the believer shall be delivered. God bless you and God keep you. Now, we are about to round up our discussion on effective prayer. We started the series one. We talked about prayer. And we particularly focused our attention on the book of Luke chapter 20, Luke chapter 9 from verse 28. We discussed the things that happened at the transfiguration when Jesus took with him Peter, James, and John. We talked about that and discussed it in very deep details, and we discussed that very thoroughly. Now, I want to say that it's a privilege that God has given us to be able to talk about His Word and get to understand some basic truth about Him. I want to say that God is faithful and God is fearful at the same time. Now, we're about to round up this, and it's very important that I state some general advices on effective prayer, which I believe we will be discussing in this particular video. Now, but the first thing which I will say, and the first thing I want you to know, is sin. You know, no matter how much you want to pray, you want to talk to God, you want to be in communication with God, the foundation standard shall, the Bible say that let him that nameth the name of the Lord, let him depart from iniquity. Now, for you to have a life that is very effective with prayer, the first thing you should do is living a life of righteousness and living a life of purity. Sin will keep you away from praying and reaching out to God. Bible says, my eyes cannot behold iniquity. So if there is sin in your life and you're living in sin and you do not want to repent of it, that will hinder you from praying effectively. That will stop you from pulling down the atmosphere of heaven to yourself. That will also hinder you from precisely getting to be able to be in the presence of God. That will stop you from being a constant conference meeting with the Father, with the Son, and with the Holy Ghost. These are very, very important things which we all should know and we all ought to know. Now, besides this, another thing which can hinder you from praying effectively, from talking to God effectively, is something that I believe is very, very important. It's something that I believe is very, very fundamental, which we shall be discussing too. Besides the fact that sin is there to stop you from listening to it, from praying and all of that, but this particular one is an aid. The reason why I'm saying it's an aid is that it will help you pray more effectively. As I said earlier, these are general advices on effective prayer. It's the Word. Because without the Word, it's impossible to be able to live a righteous and a pure life. The Bible says in the book of Ephesians chapter 5 verse 26, I believe, that you have been washed by the water of the Word. So each time you study the Bible without more. I'm not saying practicing the Bible is bad. In fact, the Bible says that the doers of the Word are the people who are actually living the Word. That's what the Bible says in the book of James, be doers of the Word. Acts chapter 1 verse 1 says that the former treaties have I written unto you, O Theophilus, all that Jesus began to do, both to do and to teach. Now, that's to show us that the very foundation of the Word of being a believer or a child of God is first of all being a practitioner of the Word, someone who does the Word, someone who believes and do what the Word says. But in these circumstances, only reading the word, only studying your Bible without more, without doing any more. Only to read your Bible daily, only to study your Bible purifies your heart. Because the Bible says so, that be washed by the water of the word. So there is a water in the word of God that purifies your heart and makes you clean. As a believer, if you read the word, of course you are purified. Because the water of the word of God has the power to purify you. Now the Bible says, "Speak unto me, the Spirit entered into me and set me upon my feet." So the word has the power to set you upon your feet. The word has the power to purify you. The word has the power to cleanse you. So in addition to the fact that sin stops you from praying, this one will help you from praying. When you study the Bible constantly, you read the Bible constantly, you meditate on the word constantly, one of the very things that is will be noticeable in your life will be that you can pray very well. You'll be a man of effective prayer. You'll be a man that can ascend up to the mountain, pull down God's presence, and have God himself confirm your voice before men. And have God give the ears of men to you so that men can listen to you and pay attention to the things which you are saying. These are very, very, very important things which we all should know. Jesus said, he said, "You are being washed by that which you've heard. The truth I've spoken to you. You are sanctified by what you've heard." Why is this so? Because the word of God himself, the word which is Jesus himself, which is the word spoken unto us in the Bible as we read, has the power to purify, has the power to sanctify, has the power to keep you pure and to keep you holy. These are things that we need to know, and these are things that we have to understand. A man that is given to a life in the word, a man that is given to putting himself into God's word and reading about it every day and proof and meditating on it, one of the things which he will notice in his life is that he's a man that is pure in heart. Purity of heart is a life that is first of all a life in the world. We are proceeding further. Another factor which I will tell us here that will help you to pray is a life that is soaked or taken up, or a life that is deep in worship. Because a man that is a worshiper is a man that can attract the atmosphere of heaven. Very, very important. Because if you are a man that is given to a life of prayer, a man that is given to a life of the word, one of the things that we will be able to notice in your life is that you are a man of worship. So worship will help you to pray effectively. Why? Because anytime there is an atmosphere of heaven, anytime the atmosphere of heaven is surrounding a man, what we see is that a man becomes a man of prayer. The man is always desirous of talking to God. The man becomes passionate, hungry for discussing and talking with God. So if we see your life as a life of prayer, if you see your life as a life that is given to the life of prayer, one of the things that we will notice and see in your life is that you will be a man of prayer. Now, the final factor which I will share with us here is faith. Effective prayer is a life of faith. The Bible says that anyone that without faith is impossible to please God. So for you to have your prayers answered, for you to have God hear as answer all your prayers, or to be effective in prayer, one of the ingredients that is an ingredient that cannot be done without is faith. Because without faith, unbelief, doubt, your prayers cannot be heard. So you need faith in God. You need faith and believing in what you have prayed for you to be a man of effective prayer. Are you praying about something? Praying about your nation? Praying about certain things that are happening? One of the things you must do for yourself is to ensure that you are a man of effective prayer. You are the man of effective prayer, and then you are the man of faith, because the two must go together. You must have faith. You must believe in God. You must believe in that which you say. The Bible says that a man that is unbelieving is a double-minded man in all his ways. That man should not think that he will receive anything from God. So for you to be a man of effective prayer. For you to be someone who can pray, you ought to have faith. You ought to have a solid belief in the word of God. You ought to have a solid belief in that which you are praying. Bible says when you pray, you should believe that receive your answer. So you pray about anything, you believe God. God, I received the answers to my prayer. God, I received that which I said in prayer, and I trust you that it is done. So for you to be able to have an effective prayer life, you ought to have a solid life of faith, a solid faith life, a life that believes God and trusts in the Lord without wavering, without doubting. That is all for now. One thing I will say, and I want you to always remember, is that effective prayer is a life that the believer should live in. It will keep you in God, to help you not to miss the rapture. In this time that we are in is an end time. It will also help you to be in constant communion with God, and to help you to live a life of righteousness and a life of purity. Now, you can comment on this video and I will get back to you. You can get me on Skype. My Skype name, which is Watcher Pius, is currently running on your screen right now. Get it and you can get to talk to me. We can do video call. I can get to minister to you personally too, right there. You can also get to reach out to me on Facebook. I'm on Facebook. I'm online. You can reach me there. Search for the name Pius Joseph and I'll be there to respond. Drop a message, send a message, and I'll be able to get back to you. I am Pius Joseph by name. God bless you. Until next time, I come your way with another video. God bless you and keep you. We shall be looking at worship in our next video. We shall be doing a series on worship. God bless you. God keep you. Thank you for watching. Until next time, have a wonderful day.